Air rage incidents in the U.S. have jumped sharply since regulators moved to impose fines back in January. But as this report tells us, the number of incidents remains high.
Air rage is on the decline in the United States after new fines were put in place in January, but the number of incidents is still twice as high as last year, according to Federal Aviation Administration data released on Thursday. As of last week, reported occurrences involving unruly airline passengers were 6 per 10,000 flights. That's a 50% drop from earlier this year. FAA Administrator Steve Dixon, in a statement, said even one incident is one too many and called air rage a, quote, serious safety threat. Numbers remain high compared to a year ago as some flyers balk at a federal face mask mandate on airplanes. Hundreds of passengers have been banned from some airlines, and some have faced $9,000 in federal civil fines for defying mask requirements. Airline staff have been on the receiving end of much of the rage, leading some airlines to cancel sales of alcoholic beverages on flights. Airline unions have called on Attorney General Merrick Garland and the Department of Justice to prosecute disruptive and violent air passengers. Senior Democratic lawmakers on Monday also requested the same from the Attorney General.
An advisory panel of the U.S. Centers for Disease Control and Prevention recommends booster shots of Pfizer's COVID vaccine. The recommendation only covers Americans age 65 and older, and some adults with underlying medical conditions, living out adults who live or work in institutions at high risk for COVID-19. The CDC decision comes a day after the U.S. Food and Drug Administration also authorized booster shots for seniors. This clears the way for a rollout to begin as soon as this week for millions of people who had their second dose of the Pfizer shot 6 months ago. An additional 700,000 doses of Pfizer's COVID-19 vaccine have arrived in the Philippines. Our correspondent Jervis Manan has more details for us. Jervis, good morning.
Yes, good morning, Mike. Due to the steady supply of vaccines arriving in the country, the IATF is now preparing to give booster shots or third shots to our medical frontliners. Vaccine czar Carlito Galvez says this might be possible at the latter end of 2021 or the early months of 2022. They said they will wait for further scientific studies, but they are readying should the need arise. After all, the bulk of our vaccine purchases will be arriving this October to December. Last night, more than 728,000 doses of Pfizer vaccines arrived in the country. 51,000 were shipped to Cebu, while 92,000 were shipped to Davao City. Vaccines czar Galvez noted that vaccination rate is increasing in Manila, Cebu, and Davao, and they are now focusing on vaccinating more people in Region 3 and Region 4A or Calabarzon, as a lot of people from these areas frequently go to Metro Manila. Galvez has also recommended to the president the vaccination of children aged 12 to 17. He says this will hasten the return to face-to-face classes. Some parents and families are skeptical about sending their children back to school if they aren't vaccinated. So far, Galvez says we can accommodate the vaccination of this population because we have a steady supply of vaccines now. He said vaccination should be done by February 2022 so we can focus on the upcoming elections in May next year. Mike.
Thanks for the update, Jervis Manahan.